Well, he's a running, he's a thumbing, he's a picking, he's a strumming, and he won't look back until the deed is done. He's a bandit, he's an outlaw, yeah, he's stranded. He's also get lost, and he's making his way onto the next track, told son. Believes he's never going back, got a six string on his back. Believes he's never going back, got a six string on his back. Looking forward to the city lights, all the tall high rises and neon signs. What all that he hoped for, all that he's dreamed. But his simple life, it was no more. Had to get out of town, had to settle the score. A train starts to run, he's moving for his life. Believes he's never going back, got a six string on his back. He's never going back, got a six string on his back. Moonlight weighing on his back, a six string sitting on his neck, finding a way to turn sorrow into gold. Smoke rising up from the stacks. He's gotta get back to the track before that train has come up and gone. Believes he's never going back. Got a six string on his back. Believes he's never going back. Got a six string on his back.
Thumbing from Montgomery, had my guitar on my back, when a stranger stopped beside me in an antique Cadillac. He was dressed like 1950, half drunk, hollow eyed. Said, it's a long walk to Nashville, would you like a ride, son? Well, I sat down in the front seat and I turned on the radio. Them sad old songs coming out of them speakers, they were solid country gold. Well, I noticed a stranger was ghost right there when he asked for a light. Well, I knew there was something strange about this ride. Well, he said, drifter, can you make folks cry when you play and sing? Well, have you paid your dues? Can you moan the blues? Can you bend them guitar strings? Well, boy, can you make folks feel how you feel inside? Well, if you're big star man, let me warn you, it's a long, hard ride. We had a crowd just south of Nashville as I turned the car around. So this is where you get off, boy, cause I'm going back to Alabama. As I stepped out of that Cadillac, I said, mister, many thanks. They said, you don't gotta call me mister. The whole world called me Hank. And drifter, can you make folks cry when you play and sing? Have you paid your dues? Can you moan the blues? Can you bend them guitar strings? Oh boy, can you make folks feel how you feel inside? Well, if you're big star man, let me warn you, it's a long, hard ride. Well, he said, drifter, can you make folks cry when you play and sing? Have you paid your dues? Can you moan the blues? Can you bend them guitar strings? Oh boy, can you make folks feel how you feel inside? Well, if you're big star man, let me warn you, it's a long, hard ride. Well, if you're big star man, let me warn you, it's a long, hard ride.
you can't find the light to guide you through a cloudy day. When the stars ain't shining bright, you feel like you lost your way. When the candle lights upon burn so very far away. Well, you gotta let your soul shine. Well, just like my daddy used to say, well, soul shine. It's better than the sunshine. It's better than the moonshine. It's damn sure better than the rain. Well, and the people don't mind. We all feel this way sometimes. We gotta let your soul shine. Shine till the break of day. Grow up thinking that I had a man. Make it on my own. Life could take the strongest man, making me so alone. Now and then I feel a cold wind blowing through my aching bones. I think back to what my daddy said. Well, boy, yeah, there's darkness before the dawn. And let your soul shine. It's better than the sunshine. It's better than the moonshine. It's damn sure better than the rain. And the people don't mind. We all feel this way sometimes. We gotta let your soul shine. Shine till the break of day. Sometimes a man, well, he can feel his emptiness. Like a woman has robbed him of his very soul. A woman too, Lord knows she can feel like this. And when your little world seems cold, you got to let your spirit take control. Talking about a soul shine. It's better than the sunshine. It's better than the moonshine. It's damn sure better than the rain. Well, and the people don't mind. We all feel this way sometimes. You know you gotta let your soul shine. And shine till the break of day. Well, you gotta let your soul shine. Well, shine till the break of day. Well, Bobby played his guitar on the harder side of town, where it's hard for a poor boy to find the money. He had dedication, well, he had the heart and soul. He somehow knew he was born to play. People said, get a real job, support your family. There's no future in the road you're taking. He never said a word. Well, that dream just kept on. Well, late at night you could hear him saying, he said, well, I'm gonna be somebody. One of these days I'm gonna break these chains. Well, I'm gonna be somebody someday. You could bet your hard-earned dollar I will. The road was a struggle. It took him 10 years to the top. Well, now he's number one on the stage in the radio. But still, I can't believe how people come from miles when it seemed like only yesterday that he said,
gonna be somebody. One of these days I'm gonna break these chains. Well, I'm gonna be somebody someday. You could bet your hard-earned dollar I will. Bobby played his hometown one full moon August night, when he heard a voice in the front row singing. It's the Sandy Head River boy with the same old hungry eyes. Well, he looked up at Bobby and said, well, I'm gonna be somebody. One of these days I'm gonna break these chains. Well, I'm gonna be somebody someday. You could bet your hard-earned dollar I will. Well, I'm gonna be somebody. One of these days I'm gonna break these chains. I'm gonna be somebody someday. You could bet your hard-earned dollar I will. Well, you can bet your hard-earned dollar I will.
All right, today we're joined in the promotion studios by Roy Saunders out of Georgia. What's going on, man?
Not much. Glad to be here.
Glad to have you. So you're touring or doing a few more shows. You've got a new song out called Stranger. Tell people a little bit about yourself, how you got into music.
So music's always kind of been around my life. My dad was a musician back in the 70s and toured around the Southeast. And funny enough, he tried to put a guitar in my hand when I was like 8, and I wish I would have done it. I wanted to be a drummer, and apparently I have no drumming skills whatsoever. So when I was about 21, I bought a guitar and started learning how to play that and learning how to play bass, and just kind of pieced everything together. And then back in 2013, started taking it kind of seriously.
Right on. You got a really powerful voice. Did that just kind of come naturally to you, or is that something you kind of worked on?
So I've actually never been a singer. I had a band in 2013. I had a band, and my brother was my lead singer, and I was a rhythm guitar player. And I moved to Savannah. My brother stayed in Atlanta, and I met up with my buddy. He's my lead guitar player now, Jay Morlock. And we started learning songs, and we both loved Garth Brooks. So that was kind of what we hit it off on. He was like, man, I can play every Garth Brooks song there is.
Right on.
And I was like, yeah, really? I was like, I can try to sing them, you know. We started learning songs, and we both were just playing guitar and no lyrics, and we had to figure out who was going to start singing. So I started and
drew that short straw, huh?
I never knew that I had a voice in there for singing or whatnot.
You know, it's odd when people, you got to get to that kind of point. You got to either be pushed there or get there naturally. And yeah, you got a real strong voice for sure. So the country stuff just kind of came naturally as well. It's just like what you listened to, what everybody was playing.
I've always been a big 90s country fan.
Right.
I grew up on it, but I also grew up with listening to 38 Special and Skinner, and my dad's from
Southern
Jacksonville,
rock and country,
so
yeah.
You know, that was always played around the house. But we also listened to James Taylor and, you know, Sade.
Yeah. Well, you know, you got to be musically diverse. You know, it helps with those the inspiration for sure. So tell me about Stranger. That's the first single that you put out, first solo single.
It is. So I wrote Stranger on a back porch back in 2009. And it was kind of just the bare bones of the song as far as musically. And I knew that there was something there with it. It was catchy enough that this needed to be a song. And I had kind of a music video playing in my head for it. But I'm terrible with lyrics and words. And when I wound up meeting up with one of my songwriting partners, and, I told him what the story of the song was, and he kind of helped me piece together, you know, the lyrics for it. And
get narrative.
Yeah. And I think when you listen to the song, it very much, if you close your eyes, you could see the same thing that I see.
Good. Yeah. Any plans to put a video out for that? You're going to try to bring that vision to reality?
I'd like to. You know, the artwork for the song kind of embraces it all. You know, it's about a guy who's running from something and you don't know what, and he's jumping trains and kind of old style. So I'd definitely be interested in putting something together, go down some old train tracks or
have to talk to Norfolk Southern or Conrail and get their permission. Be like, hey, can you open up a train car for me?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
I'm sure they'd let you do that, man. Yeah, that's really cool. What are your plans for 2020?
So 2020, I've got big expectations. You know, I took a break from music, and tried to do the whole, I have a culinary degree. So I went back into restaurants and, was doing the whole running kitchens type deal, and I was miserable. So in 2019, I decided that I was going to go full on, pursuing music, and I had a goal of doing 125 shows for 2019 and managed to do 150. So 2020, I want to up it, you know, maybe do 225, something like that.
Gotcha. Yeah.
And definitely spread the name farther than where it is right now. You know, we've got a good little fan base between, Georgia, Alabama, Tennessee, South Carolina, but want to start spreading it out the whole Southeast.
Yeah, once you get the Southeast locked down, start getting out there to Louisiana, Texas, you know, you get out there to the Midwest with your sound, they'll pick it up and run with it like gangbusters for sure, man.
That's one of my big influences now with country music is Cody Jinks.
Yeah. Texas has got it on lock right now.
You know, all those guys, that dirt road country is, to me, it's where it's at. Yeah.
It's got, it's really approachable. I mean, it verges on outlaw and kind of country, but it's got more heart. It's not quite so, it's gritty, but these guys are telling a story that everybody can relate to. It's not just this kind of, you know, blood and mud and, you know, beer. It's, they're real relatable stories. I credit, you know, some of the writers like Jason Isbell and Sturgill Simpson, people like that, that have really been, you know, pushing songwriting in that direction for the country music.
Absolutely. You know, Isbell is to me one of the best songwriters around, right up against Chris Stapleton's another one. Yeah,
absolutely.
He was a songwriter way before a performer.
Mm-hmm.
And that's kind of a lost art that you don't find anymore. That I'd love to kind of get a niche in, but it's one of those things that takes time to. You got to have 100 songs that sound terrible, and you know, then you get
find that one. Find that one. That's right. That's what we were saying earlier. Well, you were talking about having a love for food as well. Any thoughts of trying to breach the two? You know, food and music go great together.
That's true. There's a lot of guys out there right now that are doing that kind of thing.
Yeah, so. I mean, you see that kind of. Action Bronson has that show where he eats food. You've got Matty Madison. He's a musician, kind of. But yeah, do a potluck dinner where you play for everybody, kind of thing.
Well, you know, I was talking with my girlfriend about it, and we were saying that we could do something to where, you know, we'll go on tour and we'll start going to the Mississippi or whatnot, and have, you know, a TV crew follow me, and I'll go eat at this place, and then play a show there later on.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
It could work.
Yeah, one of my buddies wants to do a barbecue tour. He wants to, you know, cook barbecue for people and then play a show. It's like, well, you know, if your barbecue's good enough and your music's good enough, too. Yeah.
Right, sign me up for it. I need a treadmill, though.
Roy, thanks so much for coming by the Promotion Studios. Good luck in 2020. Where can people find social media, Facebook, that stuff?
Facebook, if you look up Roy Saunders Music, it's on Facebook, and then Instagram would be Roy Saunders Music 24. And then you can find Stranger on Spotify, iTunes, Amazon Music, Apple Music, And it's on YouTube as well, so.
Right on. And that's Saunders, S-A-U-N-D-E-R-S. S-A-U-N-D-E-R-S. All right. Check him out. Roy Saunders here in the ProMotion Studio. And don't forget to click the like, subscribe down below. That way you don't miss another ProMotion Live session.